Hidden treasure uncovered by grandson under stairs of grandparents' farmhouse. Something that everyone dreams of is getting valuable, life-changing heirlooms from their family. In real life, many self-proclaimed treasure hunters have been searching for the motherlode. But there was one grandson who didn't have to look very far to find immensely valuable items. The man lives in Tennessee and stumbled on his grandparents' hoard under the carpet of their old farmhouse. A lot of people, thankfully, grow up with many family members close by. Grandparents normally have great stories to tell their grandkids, whether the children saw them on a weekend, a holiday, or even lived with them. In many cases, though, the grandparents pass away during the children's lives and take their secrets with them. Some kids are clever and figure out the secrets that the grandparents left behind. This can happen only years later, like with the man from Tennessee when he found his grandparents' hoard. The man from Tennessee's username on Reddit is Evil English, and this is the only name we know him by. He found the treasure years after the farmhouse was left empty. His grandparents had to move out during their degrading health. In 1997, they moved to a place closer to health workers who could support them. The farm was in Tennessee, around a remote region where there was nothing around. The grandfather passed away not too long after moving out, and the grandmother couldn't bear to go live in the farmhouse by herself. The farmhouse started to become just a memory. In 2009, Evil English's father passed away. This meant that the only link to the farmhouse was him now. He was shocked that his inheritance included the old farmhouse. He left it for a long time, not really wanting to go back, but eventually he decided to give the place a visit and start packing up his grandparents' things. He drove all the way out to the old farmhouse and decided that he would declutter it and restore it to its original glory. Afterward, he would put it up for sale. This was an ambitious undertaking. It would take a lot of time, but he had to do it. But he couldn't afford the old house. He felt mixed emotions wash over him as he got out of his car and looked at the old farmhouse. Then he realized what kind of state the house was actually in. The wood of the house was starting to rot, and there were webs everywhere. The house didn't even look structurally sound. Evil English started to work on the house. After a few days worth of work, he had done a lot, but there was still much to do. One day while working on the house, he remembered something about his grandparents that put the house in a new light. As he looked at the peeling wallpaper and rotting ceiling beams, he felt a strange emotion. As he looked through his grandparents' possessions, he started to remember fond moments from his childhood. With each item he sorted, he remembered more. There were many memories in this house. His grandparents loved to collect things. He found a dusty copy of Treasure Island and suddenly could remember his grandmother reading it to him as a child. He remembered wanting to discover treasure after his grandmother read the story to him. Maybe there was treasure here somewhere. His grandfather was always fond of telling him amazing stories, and as a child, he generally believed every word. As an adult, he didn't really think they could hold any truth. Of all his stories, his grandfather's favorite was talking about back when he was a sailor. These stories always had pirates. His grandfather also wanted to discover treasure like him. As he kept sorting through the house, he felt that maybe his grandfather's stories had more weight than he gave him credit for. Staring at the closet at the bottom of the stairwell, he felt like there was something in there that was important. As he slowly moved items out of the way inside the closet, there was an old carpet there. The carpet itself was in a bad state. Once he took it out, he noticed something in its place, a circular notch on the floor. He became very curious about what lay under the carpet. There was a handle on the item on the floor. It seemed like a giant plug for the floor, but why? He could no longer wait and pulled hard on the plug to reveal something that was hidden for a long time. It was, in fact, a safe. Unfortunately, the safe was sealed shut. As he kept trying to get it open for days on end, he finally conceded and asked for help from Tim, the locksmith. Tim worked for hours until he finally got the lock off. At last, it was time to see what lay in the safe. What could be so important that it needed to be protected and hidden from everyone? Evil English wasn't going to wait to find out. He pulled open the safe to reveal a pile of bricks all surrounded by water. Was this it? Evil English suddenly remembered a pipe had burst in the house many years before and flooded a lot of the ground floor. It must have leaked into the ground floor. Evil English knew his grandparents had always collected various items over the years. His grandfather had always had an interest in pistols and had spent years showing Evil English his collection. Plus, he had a significant love of sport, which was proven with his vast collection of sports memorabilia. This couldn't be all that lay in the safe. Evil English began to pull out the bricks to reveal an entire time capsule. It looked as though it was something straight out of the 1930s, as one of the first things Evil English found was a coin book from 1937. Sadly, the outside was incredibly damaged, but thankfully the layers had protected the coins inside from the water. In fact, they were almost in pristine condition. It was as if they had just been placed in there. Evil English continued to dig deeper and deeper, but all he could find to start with was a collection of coin books. No one could believe how many had been hiding under the floor all this time. It seemed his grandmother had done more collecting than anyone ever imagined. The books weren't all that was in the safe. No, Evil English soon discovered a variety of coins that had been dumped into the safe along with a collection of water-damaged dollar bills. It kept getting stranger. Although many of the coins were standard issue versions, many pieces in the collection were rare coins. It turned out that even the standard finds could still have a high collector's value if Evil English decided to sell them. In fact, they were now worth much more than just their face value, even after being submerged in water for so many years. It looked as though Evil English had stumbled upon a gold mine. But could he really sell these items after his grandparents spent all those years collecting? Evil English soon discovered there were more than just silver coins in the safe. It turned out his grandfather had also done some collecting of his own. There were a number of pure silver bars. To top it off, the silver looked pristine. Evil English knew they could be worth a small fortune, especially as they had been protected in their boxes. Many of the bars had been engraved with markings that showcase their true history. Evil English was holding on to a piece of the past. As Evil English continued to enjoy all the finds in the safe, he suddenly found something pretty confusing. There was an old box, but it had completely rusted over. Although Evil English figured it must be an old toolbox, he wondered what it was doing down here with the other collections. It looked entirely out of place. Perhaps there were some valuable tools his grandparents wanted to protect? Whatever was inside, it must be completely ruined by now, judging by the outside. Evil English soon managed to pry open the box and find the answers to his questions. It wasn't filled with tools at all, but instead held a ton of jewelry and pocket watches. Although some of the contents had been affected by the water, most of the pieces were still in good working order. Evil English knew his grandparents must have spent many years collecting everything to fill their secret safe. He just wondered why they had never spoken of their hidden treasures. The family soon all joined in to haul out piece after piece. It wasn't long before they were left with the bottom of the safe, which looked as though it was lined with a ton of loose coins. These must have been the standard ones, not worthy of being in a case. Evil English was amazed by the finds, but had no idea where to start. It was time to turn to social media once more. It had been there to document the journey, and now it was time to ask for their help. Evil English uploaded his finds and asked if the people of the internet would be able to help in any way. Many other users came forward to offer their opinions on the water damage. Some even offered up ways Evil English might be able to save many of the pieces and restore them to their former glory. Others had bad news. Some social media users admitted that some of the items might be so severely damaged they would no longer be worth anything to anyone. Evil English knew that he wanted to keep some of the coins. After all, his grandmother loved looking through her coin collection, and the pair had spent hours searching for new additions and checking over the finds when Evil English was a youngster. They were the perfect way to remember his late grandmother. However, Evil English needed a way to preserve the coins and get them back to their former glory. It was the least Evil English could do for his grandmother. Many people were quick to offer help and advice to Evil English on how to get the coins back to looking their best. All he needed to do was clean them off, and they would soon be back up to their top value once more. However, Evil English still had no idea if he was going to sell any of the collection. Little did any of the family know they had been standing over such an extensive collection hidden underneath his house the entire time. Evil English continued to clear through the rest of the house. After all, the family still needed to get it ready for the real estate agent. He was soon joined by his brother when the pair made another discovery. Evil English had believed the secret safe was the only mystery they would find in the home. Little did they know there was another safe hiding in plain sight. It turned out their grandfather had a safe installed in the coffee table. It was time to break it open. The safe was filled with their grandfather's pistol collection and even more money. Only this time, they weren't just any dollar bills, but were, in fact, bar notes. These special notes were extremely rare, as Joseph W. Barr was once the Secretary of State. However, he was only in the position for 29 days. It turned out Evil English's grandfather had been able to get a hold of the notes and keep them safe. Now they were holding some of the rarest currency in the nation. People all over social media continued to comment on Evil English's photo as they gave their opinion on the item's worth. It turned out that some of them were worth thousands of dollars, while others only had a sentimental value that meant nothing to anyone outside of the family. Now, Evil English just needed to decide if he wanted to sell the finds or keep hold of it all. He had plenty of offers and knew it would be easy to find new owners for many of the pieces. Evil English never knew how clearing out his grandparents' house could soon turn into the biggest adventure of his life. He had finally achieved his dream of finding his own treasure island after all these years, and in the house he had imagined the whole tale in the first place. It was almost too good to be true. Now the family could enjoy looking back at the entire collection that had made their late family memories so happy for so many years. It's hard to imagine how Evil English and then later his brother must have felt when they found their grandmother's collection and then their grandfather's collection on top of that. When we lose people who were close to us, physical objects are some of the things that help us remember them in that initial period when the grief is still being processed. Holding on to something tangible then is a way of feeling close to that person. In that sense, the two safes really were treasures, but not in the financial sense. Sentimental value aside, it was clear Evil English had items with serious worth on his hands. Collectors go wild in bidding for a piece they simply have to have, and a big windfall might be in the family's future if they decided to sell. This was a serious dilemma. On one hand, there was big money to be made. On the other, these heirlooms belonged to his beloved grandparents and were collections they dedicated time and passion to. Would they have liked for them to be sold off like that? While we certainly have never met Evil English's grandparents, we might be able to suss out what they'd be thinking in such a situation. Grandparents want nothing more than for their family to be happy and secure, both financially and otherwise, and often do everything they can to make sure that happens while they're still alive. When they pass, it's unlikely for these sentiments to change. If they could know Evil English or a member of his family could somehow improve their lives, they would probably condone selling off their prized collections.